I bought my QNAP NAS because I liked the idea of automate my backup with the QNAP backup solution called Hybrid Backup Sync. I got a second NAS from QNAP to make some demonstrations on YouTube. I created an RTRR job which should save files from the other NAS every hour. The source files, which I liked to backup, have 973 GB in size. This number is important for the following. What happened next is just horrifying. The source NAS starts the RTRR backup job. Some minutes later, the folder version recycle is created on the target NAS. A du command reveals that it's about 1 TB in size. As already mentioned, the source folder has about 973 GB. After some minutes, the backup is finished, says the job log. In my case, it took 12 minutes. At this point, everything looked fine so far, but it isn't. In reality, on the target NAS, an rm command is started, which intends to delete the version recycle folder. This rm command needs 3 hours to complete. My backup schedule was intended to start the next backup 1 hour after the first. For this video, I didn't wait that long. I started the backup directly after the first job finished successfully. And now the horror is starting. The rm command already deleted some files. I could monitor it with a du command, which shows that about 200 GB have been deleted. Some minutes after starting the second backup, the folder is back at 1.1 TB. Nevertheless, the rm command is still deleting files. After the folder is back on 1.1 TB, it immediately starts decreasing in size and the lsof command reveals which files are deleted now. I raised a ticket at the QNAP support and 2 QNAP supporters had a look on this issue and they told me that this is intended behavior. Their suggestion was to choose a larger backup interval. They also told me that the version recycle folder is necessary to get the versioning correct. So what are the implications of my observations? If the version recycle folder is important for versioning and the rm command runs during a backup, your version history may be corrupted. I have no proof of it because I have no time to check all my files. Additionally, the rm command always runs for 3 hours. It does not play any role how large the delta backup was and it's consuming the HDD and the CPU. The CPU is at 50% for 3 hours in my case. My conclusion is that I have to use another backup solution to avoid getting corrupted backups and useless power consumption generated by the rm process.